You've probably heard the depressing statistic that says 70% of adults fail to obtain sufficient sleep at least one night per month. 11% report insufficient sleep every single night. There are about 20 different sleep disorders, such as insomnia, sleep apnea, RLS, and so on. And I'm sure that at some point in your life, you have had some kind of problem with your sleep yourself and wondered how you could improve it. So let me share my experience tracking my sleep with the Oura Ring 2 and what I learned out of that. Coming up. Hi, Andrey here. Welcome to Practical Health. Most people sleep for about 8 hours a day. That's the entire third of our lives. It's about 10 days per month or 4 months per year. So it is critical to understand the quality of our sleep and think about the ways we can improve it. The Oura Ring 2, this beautiful ring, tracks 12 key sleep indicators, such as bedtime, time in bed, resting heart rate, deep sleep, REM, and others. It also gives you a sleep score, a single number used to assess the quality of your sleep. The ring syncs up to a neat smartphone app and has a website that can be used to review your data online. This is examples from two nights that I tracked using the Oura Ring 2. On the first, I slept well, and not to brag or anything, but I got a sleep score of 83. The other night did not go as well. It was pretty bad and landed me a score of 54. As you can see, the Oura Ring provides a lot of interesting information to think about. Let's look at the data from multiple nights. This is the averages of my sleep indicators and weekly graphs for the last 17 weeks of 2019. Bedtime, 9:59 p.m. Wake up time, 5:19 a.m. Time in bed, 7 hours 20 minutes. Sleep efficiency, 83%. Resting heart rate, 49 beats per minute. Heart rate variability, 38 milliseconds. Respiratory rate, 13.7 breath per minute. Latency, 7 minutes. REM sleep, 1 hour 8 minutes. Deep sleep, 29 minutes. Total sleep time, 6 hours and 6 minutes. And finally, sleep score, 65. That's a ton of data to review and analyze. Almost too much, but I like the challenge. As you can see, I'm quite consistent about going to bed and waking up at the same time. But I struggle with deep sleep. I only get 29 minutes per night on average, and my average sleep score is only 65, so there is a lot of room for improvement. One thing to keep in mind is that I do take naps throughout the day, especially on weekends. Just thinking about that makes me want to take a nap right now. But the Oura Ring doesn't track those naps. It just calls them rest periods, and they are not counted toward my daily sleep score. I estimate that my naps would add about 10-15 points to my overall deep score. A quick disclaimer, sleep tracking devices are not 100% accurate. The most accurate way of tracking sleep is polysomnography, or something that's easier to pronounce, a sleep study. In a lab with a technician in attendance who records your brain waves, the oxygen level in your blood, your heart rate, breathing, as well as eye and leg movements throughout the course of the study. Even though Oura Ring 2 is considered one of the most accurate sleep tracking devices available on the market today, it detects sleep with only 96% accuracy, light sleep, deep sleep, and REM sleep with only 65%, 51%, and 61% accuracy, respectively. As it stands, some indicators like bedtime and total sleep time are quite reliable, but other metrics like deep sleep and REM are less precise. Okay, which factors did I learn impact my sleep negatively? Number one, the high temperature in the bedroom, like 75 Fahrenheit. A hot bedroom means frequent wake-ups and a bad night's sleep. Number two, noisy bedroom. The open backyard door or some noise from my twins' room increase the noise level in my bedroom and negatively impact my sleep. Number three, eating, or to be more precise, overeating before going to bed. the stomach can continue to digest food after going to bed, and the brain and body are left patiently waiting for the stomach to finish up before they go to sleep. The stomach is rude, selfish organ. Okay, number four, evening workout or steam room. My body and heart need some time to cool down, so until it happens, the quality of the first hours of my sleep is really poor. Number five, watching TV or working on my computer before going to bed. The blue light from these devices has a negative impact on my brain and sleep. Blue light blocking glasses help elevate this problem to a degree. Number six, keeping tons of things in my mind. If I forget or I'm too lazy to write down all my ideas or action items in my phone, my brain will definitely hold onto them, and it will negatively impact my sleep. And finally, number seven, caffeine or black tea in the afternoon. Not a huge impact, but it feels like this caffeine stays in my body for quite some time and negatively impacts my sleep. There are also two things that I was surprised to find had limited or no impact at all on my sleep. First, alcohol overconsumption. Let's say I decide to party hard and have like 3 glasses of wine. If I go to sleep, I'm okay, all good. And second, melatonin. Surprisingly, it has no or marginally low impact on my sleep. Finally, one very surprising observation. If I don't get good sleep, I can trick my brain into feeling good, but not my muscles. They're too smart for that ruse. An extra cup of coffee and loud music in the car can help my brain wake up nicely and stay in a good condition through the entire day. But I just can't manage to trick my muscle in the same way. They hold grudges and remember my bad sleep from the night before. So if I had a bad night's sleep, my athletic performance takes a hit. Though my brain might think that I am good and well prepared for a run or a soccer game, my performance will end up being quite poor. So that's it for today. I'll continue learning about my sleep and I hope to improve it in 2020. I'll update you on the progress along the way. If you enjoyed this video, hit that like button and leave a comment below. It will help our small channel grow. Even a simple comment like I love sleeping, or man, Andrey loves the data, will help attract more attention to our channel. And the rumor has it, when you subscribe to Practical Health channel, you'll sleep like a baby every night. Give it a try and I'll see you next time. Bye.